Britain's second longest racetrack, one of four owned by 1983 European Formula 2 champion Jonathan Palmer. Today, Palmer is also responsible for running the modern version of the championship he won himself almost 30 years ago. The Formula 2 of today is very different to the Formula 2 of yesteryear. It still pitches itself as a feeder series to Formula 1, but it is centrally run, so there are no teams, and it is single make, so there is only one type of car. That car is the Williams JPH-1B, designed by the Williams Formula 1 team and powered by a 1.8-litre turbocharged Audi engine. It's a car that's been upgraded every year since Formula 2 was revived in 2009, and today, Autosport is going to drive the latest version.
There are two significant areas of upgrade for 2012. The first is the adoption of a new brake package, which includes new monoblock calipers, and for the first time on F2, the introduction of carbon brakes. The second area are a new tyre supplier in the form of Yokohama. With this combination of upgrades, we're expecting the car, depending on circuit, to be upwards of 2 seconds a lap faster than it has been previously.
Just completed my run in the F2 car, well, my three runs in fact. It's difficult to know where to start. For somebody who's used to kind of lower level, low powered single seaters, it's all quite overwhelming to start with. The car's big, has lots of power, lots of grip, and it can be quite intimidating. But I was actually pleasantly surprised with how accessible the car was. Rather like when you drive radical sports cars, they make you feel quite competent quite quickly, and as with anything, the difficulty is then of course trying to get that last bit of performance. I was expecting, if I'm honest, something a bit more brutal when I put my right foot to the floor, but actually found that even with the turbo and its specific kind of delayed delivery, it was very smooth and quite manageable. But the biggest challenge is really is the bravery and confidence in the high speed. The car has so much more capability than I was able to access. But in the higher speed corners at Turn 1, Richie's, on the turn onto the back straight, and particularly through the last long right-hander at Coram, you can really, really feel the downforce working and the car gripping, and it's a real physical workout and really hard to hang on to, but it's a great car. Having driven the AutoGP Lola Zytec and also British Formula 3 Dallara F308, I was kind of expecting the car to fall somewhere in the middle, and I have to say it's not quite as brutal under acceleration as the AutoGP car, but it feels like a more refined car, closer to Formula 3 chassis performance. It was a great experience.